Final Cut Pro 10 is an excellent tool, but like anything, it can be frustrating to use when a problem arises. In this video, we will follow the support article from Apple titled "Resolve an Issue in Final Cut Pro 10" to help locate and fix the majority of problems. Having a backup of your data is always recommended, and the article starts by having you verify a backup has been created before starting the troubleshooting steps. In addition to having a time machine backup or using another method to copy all of the files on your computer, consult the backup article to learn how specific Final Cut Pro 10 data can be backed up. Once the backup is completed and verified, troubleshooting can begin without the risk of losing information. Step 1. Restart your Mac. Simply clicking the Apple menu and selecting Restart can resolve the majority of issues. It may also help to uncheck the Reopen Windows when logging back in box. After the computer restarts, if the issue remains, continue to the next step. Step 2. Disconnect external devices. Shut down your Mac, keep the keyboard and mouse connected, but unplug all other devices connected to the Mac. Next, reset the NVRAM by turning on the Mac and immediately press and hold the following keys: Option, Command, P, and R together. Continue to keep these keys pressed for about 20 seconds, then release the keys and allow the Mac to boot. Once booted, open and test Final Cut. If the issue is fixed, reconnect your external devices one at a time and test to see if the issue returns. It may also be helpful to restart the Mac after reconnecting each device. As the article states, if the issue only occurs with a particular device connected, you may need to update or service that device. Contact the manufacturer of that device for support. Step 3. Check Final Cut Pro 10 documentation. In addition to searching the internet for answers, Apple provides many useful articles. The majority of questions that I receive can be answered by one of these articles, so take a moment to search the Apple support site for a solution. Step 4. Check system requirements. Verify that your machine still meets the requirements for Final Cut Pro 10, as an update can require more hardware to perform correctly. Some features, like editing 360 or 4K videos, have additional requirements. Step 5. Make sure Final Cut Pro 10 is up to date. As mentioned at the beginning, make sure you have a backup of the current version of Final Cut Pro 10 before performing an update. Use the Mac App Store to verify you are on the latest version of Final Cut Pro 10. If you're not able to update to the newest version, your system may not meet the minimum system requirements. If after updating, the issue is still happening, restart your Mac and try again. Step 6. Verify installation of Pro video formats. There are so many different cameras and computer systems that use proprietary video formats. Think of these formats as different languages, and your computer needs to understand them to be able to translate the video into viewable images on the screen. When you install additional video formats, or codecs, you're teaching the computer how to read those videos. Use the App Store to verify the Pro video formats are installed. Step 7. Check media and device compatibility. After installing the Pro Video formats, there still may be additional steps you need to perform to get your device and videos to be compatible with Final Cut. Use the links in Step 7 to verify you have a compatible media format, device, and external storage device format. In most cases, you will need to go to the manufacturer's website for additional steps. Step 8. Check software compatibility. Additional software can be installed on your Mac to provide Final Cut additional capabilities. If you have installed any plugins, verify they are compatible. An update to Final Cut Pro can cause plugins to behave strangely or even stop working. If a plugin is not compatible with the latest version of Final Cut, but is required for your work, use the backup of the previous version of Final Cut to revert to a working version. Step 9. Try using another user account. If the problem is still happening after performing the previous steps, continue with this step to determine if the problem is specific to your user account or is a system-wide issue that impacts all users. Open System Preferences, click Users, and create a new user account. Sign out of your current account and sign in to the newly created one. Open Final Cut and test the issue to see if it is still present. If the issue is resolved in the new user account, we know there is probably something in the other user account that is causing the problem. Step 10, test with a new library and project. Another way to help narrow down where the problem is happening is by creating a new library and project. Hold Option when opening Final Cut Pro to create a new library. With a new library, import some media that you know is working correctly and test the issue. Don't forget to try this step both in the new user account and the original one. Step 11, reset Final Cut Pro 10 preferences. If the issue was fixed by using a new user account, returning to the original user account and resetting the Final Cut Pro 10 preferences may correct the issue. Hold down Command and Option, then open Final Cut Pro and delete the preferences. As the article states, resetting preferences doesn't affect your libraries, projects, or media. However, any custom preference settings will be reset to their default settings. Step 12. Remove and reinstall Final Cut Pro 10. The final step listed in the article is to completely remove and reinstall Final Cut Pro 10. Move the Final Cut Pro application from the Applications folder into the trash. Then, use the App Store to reinstall Final Cut Pro or pull it from your backup. If the issue is still not resolved, use the links at the bottom of the article to read additional articles that may relate to your issue. The article titled Final Cut Pro 10 Support Resources includes many additional support options. If you're still unsure, compose a tweet and include @FinalCutProHelp or send an email describing the issue to FinalCutProHelp@me.com.